What's up, fellas?
So I think I kind of have a good plan today, and here's what it is. First of all, we're going to the jetties. We're gonna see if we can harvest some food. And then after that, dude, I haven't been to the surf in such a long time, so I really wanna go back to the surf. And we're gonna take that flat boy, and we're gonna cook her up at the beach. That's the plan though. We'll see if the fish cooperate though, because you never know, dude. Jetty fishing, you never know what's gonna be out there.
Okay, I might have forgotten something kind of important here.
I think this thing is gonna be a pretty big part of today's success.
Ooh, all right, let's check the flat boy hole right here. Let's see how fast we can catch a flat boy, or maybe some rocks. It's always a struggle between fish and the rocks at the jetties. Which one will strike first? Very dirty water, actually. Not what I was looking for. Actually, but I've caught plenty of flounder in dirty water like this. Only thing is, I don't have scent right now. Just using a straight up soft plastic, no gulp today. They should still eat it up though, I do believe. If they're here, that is. There's one. Look, we got one, but it's a miniature guy. That's not an eater. He's just hanging out right on the bottom right there. Get out of there, buddy. Get out of there. I believe in you. See ya. It's always kind of hard to tell how big a flounder's going to be. Even small ones feel pretty big because they just lay flat, you know? There's one. Another dinker. Jeez. No! Sorry about that, buddy. There he goes. He's going to get out of there now. Nope, he's just going to lay flat. There he goes. He did not want to be handled. I was saying how if there's going to be this clean water here, there might be some crazy fish, but nope, we got some brown water. But that's okay, because the flounder don't care, and they're also going to eat up those bait fish. When you see those, I always say this, when you see those little tiny bait fish, there's a good chance for some flat boys in the area.
Well, you're not going to catch a fish like that. What are you doing?
Fix yourself, man. Get your life together. Ooh, that was a rock. Ooh, a rock. A rock, dude. I almost caught a rock. That's the spot right there. Guaranteed fish right here, no doubt about it. Zero doubts in my mind. We're about to catch one. Was I right, dude? Was I freaking right? Oh, no, he dropped it. That was a keeper, too. God dang it, dude. Hubris. You can't have no hubris when you're fishing, man. God dang it. That was a nice fish, too. And he's back. No, that was a rock that time. Sorry.
What's up? What are you fishing for? Because I'm not from here, so I don't know what.
In shallow here, I'm going for flounder. They hang out right here, and there's like rocks and stuff, but we're going to use a shrimp tail, the classic old-timer bait. All right, shrimp tail. Let's see what you can do, buddy. I usually always tell my baits I believe in them, but I don't know. I don't really believe in this guy. Prove me wrong, buddy. Prove me wrong. Woo. Some hurricane force winds moving in. Dude, I got one. You proved me wrong. Oh, it's a good one, too. That's definitely a keeper. There we go, baby. Stay on the line, buddy. Dude, that guy proved me wrong real quick. Ugh. Talk about some camouflage right there, especially on these jetty rocks. Nice. That's a nice one, baby. Hell yeah, baby. What's up, man? You're looking beautiful. Everyone, give your best guess. Give your best guess how big this guy is. I guarantee you're all going to be wrong. We're measuring him right now. Oh, you guys are all going to be wrong. I guarantee it. That right there. That's an 18-inch fish right there. Oh, let's see if we can get one more. All I need is one for the consumption. But I wouldn't mind catching another. Dude, I don't know. The shrimp tail. The old-timer. The freaking old-timer bait came through. Who uses shrimp tails anymore? Maybe I need to start using them more. All along. I knew it all along, baby. And there's another one. Oh, yeah. There's another one. The shrimp tail. This guy's staying down big time. This might be a big boy, brother. He's in the rock. Oh, that might be a big boy. This might be... No, it's a little one. like I said, you can never really tell what size they are, man. Look at that, he's got some cool spots on him. Thank you for the bite, brother. Just barely hooked too. See you, flat boy. Dang, two casts back to back, we got some. Now we need to see if we can get some bait before the sun goes down. It's gonna be a struggle. It's gonna go down quick here. Shrimp tails though, the shrimp tails? What? I don't even know what brand this is. Bite. Catch outdoors. Who knows? Never heard of him in my life.
Nice flounder.
Yes, sir.
Are you that guy from the videos?
That's me, man, that's me. Woo.
Somehow another fishing adventure is actually coming together, man. We came here and we got the flounder. Now we need to try and get some bait before the sun goes down. We do not have much time. We're gonna be throwing the cast net. But dude, if this works out, it's gonna be a great day tomorrow.
All there is to it, man, is throw it with your heart's desire to catch bait and you're gonna get some. The fishing gods deliver. Jeez, and it still didn't go anywhere because the wind. And we caught something. What did we catch? Some tame little pinfish. Oh no, croaker. Oh dude, these are awesome. These are awesome live bait croaker right there. Look at that. That's like trout freaking crack cocaine. Damn it, Bobby. Can't catch no bait, Bobby. Well, you know, you can't win them all.
All right, only thing left to do is flay my flat boy friend and then prepare for the surf. Prepare the gear for the surf tomorrow. Let's start cutting this guy up. And that right there is all there is to it. Every time I fillet fish, I'm getting better and better at it. Still not good, but I'm getting better. All right, you can never be sure with these things, but I think we have everything ready for tomorrow, man. Tomorrow should be an amazing day. Let's see how it goes. And just like that, it's time, man. It's the morning. Do you wanna go fishing? Cause I'm about to head out. Come on, let's go. Oh wait, there's just one thing. There's gonna be an extreme front coming in sometime today, so we're gonna see what we can get before that baby hits. We got some nice shrimps for bait. First of all, let's see if we can get some whiting on the small rods, and then we're gonna upgrade. See if we can upgrade to some bigger fish. I say that, some of the skies behind me, they're looking pretty dark, my friends. We might have to scoot out of here. All right, first up, we're starting off with some shrimps, sending it straight out there. The water looks pretty good, man. It's hard to tell the color right now because it's still super dark. But first of all, let's see if there's anything in the first gut, the wade gut. My line got real slack, boys. My line got real slack real quick. But why? But why would it do that? Why would it do that? Because we got a nice whiting, baby. That's what I've been wanting to catch, baby. That's bait. That's a good one. Dang, that's a big guy in close. I say it's a big guy for whiting. That's pretty big. Yo, check out this joker right here. He's just waiting till I go out and make a cast, and then he's gonna go steal my bait. You can't have it, brother. You can't have my bait. You can't have it, brother. I am the one, the way you can. We need a wind wall so we can start up our fire. A little bit of a change of plans here. I just got a thunderstorm warning in the next hour, and at the beach holding some lightning rods, I don't think that's a good idea. So we're gonna change up locations real quick. I'm gonna put down the camera because I don't want to be packing up when the thunder's rolling through. Well, that weather changed up real quick and it kicked me off the surf, but you know what? Screw everything, man. I just want to eat some flounder. I even had this cool little recipe ready to go, some fiery flounder tacos, and we're still gonna make them right now, so. Just saying, it would have been cooler on the beach, but you know, what are you gonna do? Some serrano peppers. Those are, they smell freaking good. Nice and spicy. Lemons. This guy holds up some freaking green circular things and he calls them freaking lemons. Come on, man. They're limes, man, they're lime. Then of course we got our nice flounder fillets. I don't know, let's just get cooking right now. All right, boys, look at them freaking beautiful fillets. We're gonna keep this real simple, but it's also gonna be real hot and real tasty. Some Creole seasoning as our base. You gotta have some black pepper. Gotta have some black pepper on everything. And now for the top secret thing I'm gonna teach you right now. We're taking one of the serrano peppers, and all we want from this is those seeds. Just let them get them seeds on the filet, and that's making my mouth water. These peppers smell really good, man. Shall we take a bite? Yeah, why not? Oh man, that's really good. Really, quite hot, but really good. And you know your man had to do it. My man Cayenne coming in just for a little bit. Just a little bit for an extra little kick. Melting some butter in the pan. Gonna lay our fillets in there. In, baby, going in. I'll tell you what, be careful with those serranos though. Them some hot doggers. Those are some pretty hot peppers right there. Tortilla time, it's tortilla time. Woo! There it is. Let's go, boys. We got our fish tacos going. All we need now is just a little bit of rabbit food. A little bit of rabbit food to top it off. A wee bit of lime on there. Beautiful, baby. Freaking beautiful. Well, gentlemen, what a turn of events there. Yesterday went so well. We got the flounder right off the bat. And then today, we went to the surf, and it didn't work out. But you know what? We got the tacos. That's all that matters in the end. Don't be eating these tacos if you can't handle a little bit of capsaicin, man.